Leaving too, or are you gonna stay?
This is our reorganization meeting. This was identified as the appropriate day to do the changeover of the commission, and then also locally, we've determined to do some of our reorganization responsibilities, choosing the chairmanship, also identifying date and time of meeting, official city newspaper, and who gets to sit at the bench. So this lineup is itemized A1 through 13, and so we'll just start down that list. Commissioner Dahl, an opportunity for you to give comments.
As I was thinking about closing remarks I would give today, my very first thought was how remarkable the people of this community are. Garden Cityans, you are supportive, engaged, and generous beyond measure. So many individuals give their time, talent, and funds, all of them working to see their community flourish. Many serve on boards and committees and do so without compensation other than knowing that they are serving the greater good. I would imagine there are few communities who could measure up to the individuals of Garden City. There are 24 departments within the operation of the city of Garden City, with many having an advisory boards made up of citizens of our community. These board members research, dig deep, study issues, and give recommendations to the city commission. To these individuals, I say a big thank you. You are so appreciated. To the county commissioners, county staff, members of economic development, USD 457, Garden City Community College, Downtown Vision, community health organizations, the Chamber, and CVB, I would like you to know how grateful I am for the cooperative spirit all of us have had in working together on the many projects in our community. To the staff of the City of Garden City, it is hard to find adequate words to express how grateful I am for your exceptional expertise and professionalism. I have seen over and over again in every department the pride the staff has in their city, their jobs, and their commitment to the people they serve. And they don't just do the work of their own departments, but share in the workload of other departments when the need arises. Each of these departments run efficiently, effectively, and have pride and care for their equipment, and without fail, take care of each other. As a city commissioner, of course, we spend a great deal of time with City Manager Matt Allen. Matt is a consummate professional with management skills and knowledge that I am always in awe of. This community and commission are fortunate to have you as our city manager. Thank you, Matt. Besides Matt, I've had the pleasure to work one-on-one with many staff members, so I would like to also thank Assistant City Manager Jennifer Cunningham, City Council Randy Grizzell, City Clerk Celine Hurtado, Assistant to the City Manager Steve Cottrell, Department Heads and Directors Melinda Hitz, Mike Murhead, Caleb Kettner, Chief Michael Utes, Chief Alan Shelton, Sam Curran, Rochelle Powell, Christy Newland, Ashley Freeberg, Fred Jones, and Ali Medina, for your dedication and for working with me and my fellow commissioners as we worked on matters of the city. I appreciate each and every one of you. And finally, to my fellow commissioners, as I look back on the nearly 5 years we have served together, there are two mantras that immediately come to mind, which are big, audacious ideas, financially sound, of course, and how can we make this happen? All of us have focused on building a better community, a better business environment, a better quality of life, and a better place to call home. I thank each and every one of you for your dedication, objective decisions, and your valued friendship. I would like to welcome incoming commissioners Lindsay Burns, Troy Unruh, and returning commissioner Melvin Dale to this incredibly dynamic organization. Thank you, Garden City, for allowing me to serve you. It has been my honor and extreme pleasure to do so. I hope that I have fulfilled your expectations when you voted me in as a city commissioner of Garden City. Thank you.
Commissioner Law, this is an opportunity for you to make comments.
It's an opportunity for me to fail at following up on that, too, I assure you. I could easily just say, you know, that I echo everything Janet said because it's all true. But I served my time and I earned my few minutes, so here we go. You know, the city, in the end, is its employees and all those people she listed and the rest of them, previous department heads and previous employees that have moved on for whatever reason. Rarely do you not see people that care more about the outcome of their job than the pay or anything like that, and that's all important. But we have such an amazing employee base, so that's been made the job a lot easier. You mentioned, and it dawned on me while I was thinking about these things, that these guys kind of go unthanked once in a while, but Randy and Jake, you know, solid, steady counsel is very important, and we always get that with those guys. The people that take time to serve on advisory boards, you know, key stuff. They send us recommendations. Most of the time, I think, followed them. There was a few times we didn't, but I would hate to see a place where there's 100% agreement 100% of the time. You know, I think that's always the best way. So to those people who have served in the past, present, or thinking about in the future, thank you very much. Our partners around the community, the county, the college, the school district, economic development, chamber, convention tourism, downtown vision, you know, so many other organizations that when it's time to figure it out and how can we make this work, then those people are always willing to come to the table or call us to bring us to the table and make things happen. And that all stems from the people of Garden City and Finney County, and I think as Commissioner Dale mentioned, that's, you know, that's why we're amazing. We have amazing people in this area, and we make that work. We set goals, we invest in the future, and we accomplish some things, and I'll always be glad to have been a part of that. My time as commissioner has been rewarding, exciting. Has it been perfect? No. But pretty darn close, and for that I say thank you. And I think all that's left now is to congratulate Commissioner Dale on his reelection and Lindsay and Troy on coming on, and I guess we'll start referring to you guys now as Commissioner Burns and Commissioner Unruh. So congratulations and welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, and Mayor Dale, it's an opportunity for you now to provide some comments as your term in the chairmanship ends. And then once that's concluded, Commissioners Dahl and Law will step down, and then you will join Commissioners Burns and Unruh to have the oath of office administered to you by the city clerk.
All right, thank you, Matt. I'm not going to make a big speech because I'll be back in 4 years, and so I'll save some of my time till then if Matt remembers that. So I have to agree with with two people that are about to depart this commission with some degree of sadness, because we became a group of five almost 5 years ago, and in that 5 years we've worked together well. We tackled every problem. Sometimes we didn't agree, but most of the time we did. But we achieved a lot, in my opinion. We also have to give thanks to city management in years past, and we'll go back a long way to be truthful about it. We can go, all those people set this town up to grow in the proper direction. So city managers going way back, commissioners going way back, did a lot of things that we as commissioners got to sit on the bench and enjoy the development that has come into our community in the last 5 years. And if you look at what has happened, you could look out and see what's out and our new and our shopping areas, those items that have come into play, the DFA, the new trucking company that's in, just many things, many parks, many walkways, many things that this commission has had the opportunity to give back to the community, because we were blessed by our predecessors giving us that opportunity. We're going to see a lot in the future. We were blessed in November because of the you people and people out there in TV land that voted in our sales tax. We're going to see some nice things come in that's going to be great for our community. It's going to be needed if we continue to grow at 1% annually. So we're going to need more housing, more recreation, more parks, and we're working on it all the time. So with that, I'm going to say, I'm going to miss my two colleagues. I'm going to welcome the two new commissioners, and I'm going to look forward to having the opportunity to work with both of you. I may not agree with you, but I will work with you, and we will get the job done for our city. And this is our city, and they are our families. Thank you.
Music, and when it stops, you grab a chair. Please join the other commissioners in the bench, and we'll go through the rest of the.
There you go. See what this is like. Matt, before you get started, I need to make a correction.
Okay.
And C. Lynn normally catches me, but she did not today. C. Lynn, do we have a quorum?
A little late.
All right. So the new commission has been seated, which is number 5. Now, for the first action item for this commission, the selection of a chairperson of the board who shall assume the duties and title of mayor.
I'd like to nominate Roy Cessna for mayor.
I'll second that. If no discussion, I'll say all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All opposed say nay. Carried.
Right. Congratulations. And now item 7. Commissioner Dale, you can choose to do this from behind the bench or out here in front, which
normally
you normally
do
for the
front.
Picture.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's come out front. Have the two of you come out.
Yeah, that's big. That's a new one.
I'll give it to him. A good
whack.
And please, anybody that has cameras or wants to take pictures at any point today, feel free. The room is yours.
Oh. You should probably switch these around. Well, I'll say, first off, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you for a great job. Well done as being mayor over the last few months. It's been You've done a great job for Garden City, and more success to come as you serve on the City Commission.
Well, thank you, Roy. It's been an honor to serve with you, and it was an honor to be driving around Washington, D.C. in March by Roy. We was well prepared for the weather and everything, set
Mayor Cessna. Item 8 is an opportunity for you to make some comments if you'd like.
Well, it's really hard to kind of follow up with what all the comments were made by the former commissioners and the former mayor, but we do have an outstanding staff here in Garden City. We have a great city, and we should be proud of who we are and where we're going in this community. And we really are Garden City, and we should be proud of the vision and the direction we're going. I'll just kind of leave it at that. You know, we've got a number of goals that are already set in place, like the mayor noted that we passed the sales tax, so that'll get us quite a ways into the future and through this current year. But again, what an outstanding city. I couldn't ask for a better place to work, live, and raise a family, and you should all be proud of where you live here in Garden. So on that note, I have one other quick kind of suggestion for our former commissioners. They mentioned advisory boards. We do have openings on advisory boards. So if you would like to still be actively involved in the community, thank you for your service and your dedication to our community. We do have openings. So please, there's applications available, and you can check off what you would like to do and help and serve in our community. So. On that note,
ready to move to item 9, the selection of the vice chairperson who shall assume the duties and title of vice mayor and serve as the chairperson in the absence of the mayor.
I'll make a motion to nominate Dan Fankhauser as the vice mayor.
There's been a motion. Is there a second? I'll make the second on that. Any discussion? No discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. Passed. Congratulations.
Item A10, the commission's asked to designate its rules of order, which would be followed in its conduct of meetings. Just a note, the commission presently follows Division 2, Article 2 of the Code of Ordinances. If you want to continue that, the appropriate motion would be to adopt the rules of order currently being followed by the commission in Division 2, Article 2 of the Code of Ordinances.
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
I'll second it.
Any other discussion on that item? None being, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. That passed. Number 11.
Item 11, discussion regarding the time and place for regularly scheduled meetings to be held, which, if changed, would need to be done by ordinance at the next regularly scheduled meeting. The current practice of the commission is to hold the regular meetings on the first and third Tuesdays of each month at 1 p.m.
I'll make a motion to approve the meeting scheduling the first and third Tuesday of each month at 1 p.m.
Second.
There's been a motion and a second. Any other discussion on that item? None being, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay.
Item 12, the governing body consideration is asked to consider the personnel authorized to be seated at the commission bench. Current practice authorizes the city clerk and the city attorney to be seated at the commission bench. The appropriate motion, if you want to continue this practice, would be to authorize the city clerk and the city attorney to be seated at the commission bench.
I'll make a motion to follow the practice of authorizing the city clerk and the city attorney to be seated at the commission bench.
There's been a motion.
Second.
There's been a second. Any other discussion on that item?
Well, ceiling's pretty ornery, so I don't know. I'm kind of wavering on this one.
Ornery?
Okay.
No, that's all. Oh. As long as she can behave herself.
Okay. Any other discussion? None being, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay.
And the final action under this category is the designation of an official newspaper as provided by state statute. The current practice designates the Garden City Telegram as the official city newspaper. And if you want to continue that practice, the appropriate motion would be to designate the Garden City Telegram as the official city newspaper.
There's been a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a second. Any discussion on that item? None being, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, nay. Now we're on to item 2. Pledge of Allegiance to the flag and invocation.
I think that's error in this place there. Yeah.
Okay.
The
moving on then.
Item 3 governing body is asked to consider and allow the mayor to proclaim January 8th, 2018 as Janet Doll Day in Garden City, Kansas.
Is there a motion on that?
I'll make a motion that we consider the...
Today, the
8th is Janet Doll Day in Garden City, Kansas.
There's been a second. Any other discussion on that item? None being, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay.
All right, very good. And if you'll...
I'll come down.
Here, okay.
Your day's almost up, so we better hurry.
Yeah.
The proclamation reads, whereas Janet Doll has served faithfully as a member of the Garden City Commission since April 2013 and served as mayor from 2015 to 2016, and whereas Commissioner Doll has played a vital role in the growth and development of our community, and whereas Commissioner Doll's performance of duties and responsibilities as a member of the governing body has been characterized by excellent and constructive contributions to municipal government in Garden City, and whereas Commissioner Doll has dedicated many years to representing people of all ages, races, ethnicities during the deliberation of community issues, and whereas Commissioner Doll's achievements, exemplary conduct, passion, and sense of fairness demonstrated in all her activities have earned her a special place in our hearts and minds of the people within this organization. Now, therefore, I, Roy Sessman, Mayor of the City of Garden City, Kansas, do hereby deem it an honor and a pleasure to proclaim January 8, 2018 as Janet Doll Day in Garden City, Kansas, and urge all citizens to acknowledge and express their sincere appreciation and thanks for her significant contributions to the community, and highly commend the manner in which she has carried out her responsibilities as a member of the Garden City Commission. Signed and sealed this 8th day of January, 2018.
Serving until January 8th, 2018, with the term as mayor in 2015 and 16. Thank you. You can have that back.
Congratulations.
And item B, the governing body is asked to consider and allow the mayor to proclaim January 9th, 2018 as Chris Law Day in Garden City, Kansas.
I'll make a motion that we proclaim January the 9th, 2018. Chris Law Day in Garden City, Kansas.
Is there a second?
Second.
I've got a motion and a second. Any other discussion on that item? None being, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, nay.
The proclamation reads, whereas Chris Law has served faithfully as a member of the City of Garden City and the Commission since April 2011, and served as mayor from 2016 to 2017. And whereas Chris Law has played a vital role in the growth and development of our community, and whereas Commissioner Law's performance of duties and responsibilities as a member of the governing body has been characterized by excellent and constructive contributions to municipal government in Garden City, and whereas Commissioner Law has dedicated many years of representing people of all ages, races, and ethnicities during the deliberation of community issues, and whereas Commissioner Law's achievements, exemplary conduct, passion, and sense of fairness demonstrated in all his activities have earned him a special place in the hearts and minds of the people within this organization. Now therefore, I, Roy Sessman, Mayor of the City of Garden City, Kansas, do hereby deem it an honor and a pleasure to proclaim January 9th, 2018 as Chris Law Day in Garden City, Kansas, and urge all citizens to acknowledge and express their sincere appreciation and thanks for his significant contributions to the community, and highly commend the manner in which he has carried out his responsibilities as a member of the Garden City Commission. Signed and sealed this 8th day of January 2018, Roy Sessman, Mayor.
During the meeting.
All right, everybody's welcome to join us across the hall.